Notion has a brand new exciting feature in database automations. They've just released recurring database automations, which means that you can set up an automation to run in regular cycles. I've been having a lot of fun trying out different use cases for this, which include things like recurring email reminders and updates, daily status changes at the end of the day, and more, which I'll be sharing with you in this video. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first go over how to use recurring database automations. So in order to use this feature, you do need a database. So I'm just going to go ahead and add one here, inline and plus empty database. As long as you have any kind of database and you have the plus plan or higher, you'll be able to go to this lightning bolt mark over here. And when you click plus new trigger, you'll now see that there is this every with a new icon here that you can add. And then you can choose the frequency. So every day, weekday, week, and so on can be chosen here. So let's say I choose every day, and then you can choose a time slot that you want this automation to occur. So let's say that I want it to happen at 9 a.m. And when you want this automation to start happening, so whether that's tomorrow or someday in the future, and then you can also set an ending time as well. Then there's also the option to change the time zone, and then finally make sure to check your next occurrence so that you know exactly when this is going to start occurring. And that's basically the recurring database automation. And when you do add this one, you'll notice that you can't add any other trigger. So this is the only one you can add. And then every day at this time, you can assign certain actions to happen, whether that's adding a page to this database, editing a page somewhere, and so on. And what's really interesting about this is that you can actually do recurring things that have nothing to do with the database itself. So you could even send an email every day at a certain time and not even reference the database. So I think that's something that's really interesting about this recurring feature. The other thing is that you can do basically the same thing now as you do here with database template. So let's say that you always have a daily journal. And in the past, what you would need to do is to set up the repeat here. And let's say it's every day, and you would set it up here so that this daily journal would appear into your database at a certain time every day. You can now do the same thing by going to the lightning bolt mark here, add the new trigger, which is every day, for example, and then add new action to add a page to, let's say, this database, which we've renamed now to recurring. And then you can choose that template that we've set up here, and it's going to do exactly the same thing. So you might wonder, so why would you actually use this feature as opposed to the database templates? Well, one really interesting thing that you can do, for example, is that you can change the name to using a formula. So if you do something like this or at date triggered, it's always going to show that at sign. You can actually do more custom things by going to the formula here, and then you could do date triggered, but then instead you could do format date so that it actually formats that into a specific format that you'd like. So if you don't want to see the year, you could edit that as well. So you just have a lot more flexibility in terms of how you want to title that recurring template. So that's one way that I can see that it would be slightly different, as well as the fact that you can pair that with different kinds of notifications. Let's first start with a very basic use case that I found that I think could benefit everyone. That is that when you add a new page automatically to daily journal or some kind of daily task, you can pair that with a notification so that you also get notified that you have this daily journal that you need to write. I'm going to go ahead and add a database here. So I'll add an inline database plus empty database, and I'll just title this daily journal recurring. What I'm going to do is create an automation that's going to add a new entry to my daily journal database and also send me a notification telling me that I need to journal today. I'm going to go ahead and click the lightning bolt here, and my new trigger is going to be every day. I want to add an action to add a page to this daily journal recurring. I'll write today's journal. And then I can add an action, which is to send a notification. And in this case, I'll send it to myself. And I can now add a custom message. So now I can type a message. And I can also link it to that specific journal. So I'm going to go ahead and now use a formula property here, and I'm going to add a plus and then add page added. So now it's going to reference the page that you just added. I'm going to save. So I should be getting a message that saying, remember to journal today. You can find today's journal here with the new page that's added every day. Just so that we can see exactly what this notification looks like, I'm going to go ahead and add a time that's coming up soon. And now let's wait and see what happens when this journal entry should appear. So here's an example of what that automation for the daily journal would look like. So you can see here, organized notebooks automation sent you a message, daily journal recurring, and it says, remember to journal today. You can find today's journal here. And then if I click here, it's going to take me to exactly that page that was created for today's journal. So this is also a really useful use case that previously you wouldn't really get a very custom notification for things like added pages, but now you can do that really easily. The next use case I wanted to share with you is one where you can see that it doesn't necessarily have a direct tie to the database that you're working with. This one is with a form, and to create a form, you can easily do that by typing /form, and that's exactly what I did here. I'm just saving some time by already having the form built here. And basically what I did was go to the automation button here, just like with the other automation. And I set a trigger, which is in the recurring. And let's say that for this one, I want it to be sent every 3 months. So every 3 months, I want to send an email from organizednotebook.info@gmail.com to everyone who works in my company. Then I could do something like this with a subject line, fill out this employee satisfaction survey. I have a custom message here with a link to that survey so that the employee can fill it out directly from there. So this is a really cool use case where you can basically automatically send out emails, which I think is really cool. And if I click done, it's going to now be set so that it sends out every 3 months. So here you can see an example of what would get sent if this was sent out automatically. So it would say the message that we added here. Since it's sending from here, you can also see all of your BCC. So that's really useful. And if I click this link, it's going to link to that form that I created. This next use case is really exciting for me because I can see myself using this one in my daily task system. This one is that you can change the status at the end of the day or really early in the beginning of the day to change the status of a task. And I think this is really cool. Let's say that I have this task database where I have columns for each status, not started, in progress, done, but I also have two columns for tasks I want to do tomorrow and tasks I plan to do today. This one, send email to potential partnership. If I think that I want to do this tomorrow, I could just move this into my tomorrow column so that I know that this is what I should do tomorrow. But the problem is when it is tomorrow, it's not going to show up in my today column without this automation. But now with this new recurring automation feature, if I go to the lightning bolt here, you can see that I've already set this up, but basically every day, it's going to edit the page that matches the filter that the status is tomorrow inside of my tasks database, and it changes that status to today. So it basically moves all of your tomorrow tasks into your today column, which I think is really useful, and I will probably be adding this to my own task system. Just so that you can see exactly how to build this, I'm going to delete this one, and I'll also delete this one. So basically you just have to add the trigger, which is every day. You can set the time. In this case, I would recommend you to check the time so that it actually does this action before you wake up. Say that it happens at 3:15 a.m. every day. And that new action is to edit pages in, and then I'll select the database, which in this case is the tasks database. And instead of editing all the pages, I'm going to add a filter where the status is tomorrow. Then I'm going to edit that property, the status, to be today, and then done. Tomorrow, when I wake up, I'm going to see send email to potential partnership already in my today column here. This final use case, I'm really excited to share with you because this was a really nice surprise find for me as well. And this is that you can actually send out recurring customized update notifications, which, for example, could show you exactly how many tasks are overdue and which ones you need to do, along with even a link to that particular task. The first step to doing this is that you need a, for example, task database. This can even be project, any kind of database where you want to get information out of it sent to you on a daily, weekly basis so that you're updated on all of the statuses, can work really well for this. So in this case, we have the tasks and I only have status, name, and a due date property here. So if you want to follow along, you can also create these. Then we need to actually create two more databases in order for this to work. So the first one I'm going to be adding is daily task statuses. I'm going to go ahead and type /database. I'm going to call this daily task statuses and recurring notification. This is basically just as a intermediary so that we can send over that information to a database that's going to send us an email. So this one is going to be called daily task status. And all I want to do is collect the information that I want to send over in my email. So in this case, what I want to know is how many tasks are overdue here, how many tasks are due today that's not complete, and also to link to those tasks. For that, I'm going to be adding several formulas. And before I do that, I do need to also add a relation to this tasks database. So I'm going to go ahead and relate this one. I'll go ahead and choose this one. So tasks recurring notification, I'll add a two-way relation. And one really important thing is that all of these need to be filled in with this daily task status. So I'm going to already do that as well. So I want all of these to have that. If you want every new task entering here to have this already, then you should add a new template, which already pre-fills this in, and we can call this new task and click out and then set this one as a default. So now if I add a new task, you can see that it already gets tagged by this one. So now you can see that all of these appear here. And now we can start adding the formulas. So I'm going to go ahead and look for the formula property. And the first one is going to be number of overdue tasks. I want to calculate how many overdue tasks I have. So for that, I'm going to go ahead and choose task recurring notification. And what I need to do is put a dot here and then filter out everything where, first of all, the task is not done yet. So I want two filters here. So I'm going to go ahead and add the and formula so that I can check if that current task status does not equal done. And also I want to make sure that the current dot due date is greater than today. And now I've basically filtered out everything except ones that are not done and also overdue. And then I'm also going to check the length, so how many there are, and then save. So now I can see that I have one overdue task. So I'm now going to duplicate this one. And instead of overdue, I want to see all the tasks that are due today. So instead of due date being greater than today, I'm going to say equal and save. And now you'll see that there's two tasks that are due today. The next thing I'm going to do is duplicate this one. And I just want to see the links to those tasks here. So I'm going to name this one overdue task. I'm going to edit this so that we remove the links. And I'm going to do the same here as well. Duplicate this one and I'm going to remove the length. And I'll also change it so that the name is tasks due today. So now we have the number of overdue tasks, the overdue task itself, number of tasks due today, the links to those tasks here. So we basically have all the information that we want to send ourselves on a daily basis. So the third step is going to be to create a third database, which is going to act like a notification center. So I'm going to go ahead and add another database here inline, and I'm going to call this notification center recurring notification. What I need to do now is to add the automation that's going to give me all of this information in a really nice, neatly packaged email every day. To do that, I need to relate this to the daily task statuses. So I'm going to look for that database. I'm going to add a two-way relation, add relation. Now I have this connection here as well. So I want to add a new page to the notification center at daily intervals, which are going to send me the specific information in the daily task statuses. To do that, I'm going to click the lightning bolt mark here. The new trigger is going to be every day. I want every day to first add a page to the notification center, and I'll choose this one, and the name is going to be daily status. I'm going to edit the property, which is the daily task status, so that it's always the same page that I've added here. So that's why this is like an intermediary to kind of send the information over. The next action is going to be to send an email. And here I'll send it to myself in this case. And the subject is going to be today's task statuses. So here I can add my message. Hi, today you have, and then I'm going to use the formula function. So here I can do plus and then start pulling up the information. So I'm going to take the page added dot, and then I'm actually going to use the daily task statuses, the recurring notification. And since you can add multiple of these, you actually have to do first to make sure that you get the first one that's added here, and then dot, and then now you can access all of this information. So today you have, and then number of tasks due today, plus, and then tasks due. So the first message is going to be how many tasks you have due today. And then you can also write these tasks are, and then you can have links to them here by putting the plus sign. And just to make it fast, I'm going to copy this in like this and then change this one to tasks due today. So now it's going to show these tasks are, and then all of the tasks. Now I can do another plus sign. And then I can now showcase the tasks which are overdue. So I can do another enter, shift enter, so that there's more space here. And I'll do you have, and then let's go ahead and add the overdue tasks. So again, I'm going to just copy this one like this and then change the last one to be number of overdue tasks, and then plus sign task period. And then I'll do another shift enter, these are, and then I'll do another quotation mark plus sign, actually like this, and I'll paste this part in again, so the page added, and then instead I want the overdue tasks, so I'm gonna choose this one, overdue tasks. I'll do plus sign here and then add more text. I'll say here, make sure to check in to these and hope you have a nice day. So that's basically the message. You see all of your number of tasks due today. You can see all of the tasks due today as links. Then you have all of your number of overdue tasks, and then your overdue tasks as links here, and then a nice message at the end, and then save. So basically you have this message. And just so that we can see exactly what email we get sent, I'm going to go ahead and choose a time here that's going to send this email to me pretty much immediately. So I can send it to myself at, let's say, 9 p.m. today, and I'll enable it. So now let's see what kind of email we get. So here's the result of the email sent from the automation. As you can see, you have the exact message that was created in that automation. Hi, today you have two tasks due. These tasks are, and then you can actually click these open to go to that exact task, which is super useful in these emails. I found that it doesn't work as well if you, for example, send it to your notification on your phone. It actually doesn't really show these links, but with the email, it works really well. Then here it says you have one task, and I actually forgot to add the word overdue, so it doesn't show here, but these are actually the overdue tasks. And if I click this one, you can see that it is the overdue task. And then I have my nice message here. Make sure to check into these and hope you have a nice day. So as you can see, it is a little bit hard to edit these, but once you have everything edited correctly, then it's always every day going to send this to you. And I think this is really cool way to dynamically send information in a customized way that's not just the native Notion notification system. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you've discovered any interesting use cases for recurring database automations. I'd love to hear about them. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to add them below, and I hope to see you all in the next video.